unless you've been living under a rock, you've heard of the phenomenon known as AMC's Breaking Bad. Well, we got the chance to sit down with Donna Nelson, a chemistry consultant for the show, to find out a few things. But before we get to her, here's a few things you need to know first. Walter White is a high school chemistry teacher who's diagnosed with lung cancer. He breaks bad and starts cooking methamphetamine to pay for his medical treatments and to support his family. Walt's meth is the purest meth around, gaining him the nickname Heisenberg. Oh, and because Walt has turned into an unstoppable force in the drug dealing community. Anyway, while creating the series, Vince Gilligan, the producer of Breaking Bad, talked to Chemical and Engineering News, which Donna happened to read.
I saw that Vince was saying, we really want to get the science right, but none of my writers and I have a science background, so we would really appreciate constructive comments from a chemically inclined audience.
So Donna made her way out to Burbank and met with the writers. They asked for her input on everything from what makes a person go into chemistry to how teachers talk to students, essentially getting Walt's motivation from a real chemist. Eventually, they moved to the more technical side of things.
One of the specific first things that they did was a lecture that Walter was doing on alkenes to his high school kids. They sent the script by me and asked me to sort of make some suggestions and clean it up. And at the end of that, they said, is there anything that Walter might have written on the blackboard? And I said, well, I can send you some alkene structures. And I did. And they reproduced those exactly up on the blackboard so you can see it.
Breaking Bad took the steps to ensure most of the science presented on the show was accurate, down to the tiniest details.
To us who are educated in science, whenever we see science presented inaccurately, it's like fingernails on the blackboard. It just drives us crazy, and we can't stay immersed in the show.
Along with keeping the chemistry component accurate, Breaking Bad also took their actors into consideration.
I remember when they first asked me some questions about the P2P method, and I said, well, you know, there are two steps. The first step is always the same, but the second step can depend upon the reducing agent. And I said, which reducing agent do you want me to use? And they said, well, we don't know. What could we use? And I sent them a list, and there was one that was just simply aluminum mercury. And they said, oh, use that one. It'll be easy for the actors to say.
Safety, cost, yield, nah. They'll pick the reducing agent based on what's easiest to pronounce. All the equations on how much meth could be produced from a certain amount of methylamine is actually 100% accurate, with aluminum mercury as the reducing agent. But I mean, this is still a fictional TV show. Some artistic license had to be taken.
The powder blue meth that you see is really sort of like Walter's trademark. In real life, meth would not be powder blue like that. The meth would be colorless.
So we know methylamine and aluminum mercury are used to create meth. But for those of you who think the show might actually give away to make illegal drugs, well, think again.
Vince has involved DEA agents from the very beginning. I mean, they approve everything that he puts on the screen. They know exactly what an illicit meth lab looks like. They helped him know which critical steps to omit, or, you know, slight changes, or in some cases, things to discuss that really don't make any difference.
Shows about drugs can be pretty serious and controversial, and some serious questions can arise.
Will it corrupt the minds of our young children? I tell them no. I think that the lifestyle that Walter is living, it doesn't glorify the drug culture at all. I'm on Skylar's side. She's a woman, and so I think she's becoming a stronger character in the show. And so I'm going to be watching to see if she's, you know, becomes stronger.